In the previous class, we have gone through the theory part of the circular tanks with rigid joints between floor and walls. So today we'll take one example of a circular tank with rigid joint, and we'll try to solve it by using analytical method, and then we'll see how the tables given in IS 3370 part 4 can be used to get the moments. So the data for this is design a circular tank with fixed base for capacity of 4 lakh liters. The depth of water is to be 4 meter, including a freeboard of 0.25 meter. Use M25 grade of concrete and mild steel reinforcement. Assume Poisson's ratio, that is mu, is equal to 0. The tank is 3 at top and rests on ground. The density of water is 9.8 kilonewton per meter cube. Okay, so this thing is given to you we are supposed to design a circular tank with fixed base for a capacity of 4 lakh liters, and we will be using analytical approach to solve this. So because in exam you are not allowed to sit with IS 3370 part 4. So we'll see the analytical method in which, by solving the differential equations, you can get the solutions, and we'll also see a similar example using tables given in IS 3370 part 4. So here, given data . So you have been given a circular tank with fixed base and free at top. Then the capacity required . is equal to 4 lakh liters, and which is equal to 400 meter cube of volume. Okay, because your 1 liter is equals to 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube, because 1 liter of volume or 1000 liter of water is equals to 1 m cube. The volume occupied by 1000 liter of water is equal to 1 meter cube. And total height is given to you, that is capital H, that is 4 meter. And the effective height is equal to 4 minus the freeboard of 250 mm given in the data, so it will be 3.75 meter. And the concrete grade is M25 and steel is mild steel. Okay, mild steel reinforcement. And the density of water is given to us, that is 9.8 kilonewton per meter cube. Okay, so with this we'll start the design. So first step is to dimension. Based on the required capacity, we'll first find some dimensions of the tank. So dimensions of tank satisfying the requirements. Okay, so let D is equals to dia of the tank, that is in meter. So this implies you have pi by 4 d square into the effective height is 3.75, because this much height will be occupied by water, and the 0.25 is the freeboard. Okay, this is freeboard. So this should be equal to 400. So this implies your D is equal to square root of 400 into 4 divided by pi into 3.75. So this comes out to be 11.65 meter. Okay, so let us provide D is equals to 11.7 meter. Okay, so now we have the diameter of the tank, we have the height of the tank as well. So the next step is to determine the hoop tension and bending moment. Determination of hoop tension and bending moment. So here H is equals to 4 meter and D is equal to 11.7 meter. So now assume thickness of the wall, assume thickness of wall T is equals to we'll use the formula used for the preliminary dimensioning of the members subjected to axial tension only. So these members subjected to axial tension only. Okay, and in this topic we have seen as a preliminary dimensioning for preliminary dimensioning you can assume a thickness either using this this table or based on the some empirical equation. It was 30 h plus 50. So based on that expression, it was 30 h plus 50. Just let me check it again. See, this was the formula. This using this empirical formula, you can get the thickness as a preliminary dimension for preliminary dimensioning. So here, so this will be in mm. Okay, so it is 30 into your h is 4 meter plus 50, so this will be 170 mm. So this is 170 mm. So that is t is equals to 0.17 meter. Now we have now thickness as well, so we can now find the moment of inertia of the tank of the wall. Moment of inertia is equals to I, that is equals to T cube by 12. It was T cube by 12, 1 minus mu square, but in the data we have been given that the Poisson's ratio is 0. So this will be here we have M25 with Poisson's ratio of 0. Okay, so this term will be equal to T cube by 12 only. So it is 0.17 whole cube by 12. Okay, see, this is 1 minus 0. So this comes out to be 4.094 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter raised to the power 4. Next we'll find out the factor k. Now this k, in the previous lecture we have defined this this k . See this term we have taken as k to the power 4, okay. So this is your this term is k raised to the power 4 is equals to 4t by id square. So k is nothing but fourth root of t by id square. Okay, so fourth root of, or you can say k to the power 4, you can find in terms of k to the power 4. So this will be omitted. Yes, so k to the power 4 is equal to t by id square. Now t is 0.17 divided by 4.094 into 10 to the power minus 4, that is I, moment of inertia, into d, that is 11.7. So this will be 3.033. So we can also find k to the power 4 into I is equal to 3.033 into 4.094 into 10 to the power 4. So this will be equal to 12.418 into 10 to the power minus 4. Then we also require the value of k alone. So k is equals to take the fourth root of this value, you will get is, so it is 1.3197, okay. And you also require the value of k into h, okay. These are the various terms in the differential equation. So we find all of these values so that we can directly put these values. So it will be 1.3197 multiplied by h is 4 meter, so that is 5.2788. So, and if you remember, the solution of this differential equation form d raised to the power 4 y by dx raised to the power 4 plus फोर के रेज टू द पावर फोर इंटू वाई इज इक्वल्स टू गैमा एक्स बाई ई आई इज गिवन बाय y is equals to gamma x by 4 e I k to the power 4 plus e raised to the power kx into a sine kx plus b cos kx प्लस ई रेस्ट टू द पावर माइनस के एक्स इंटू सी साइन के एक्स प्लस डी कॉस के एक्स। So for walls with fixed base and free top, the first boundary condition is at x equals to h, that is at the base, your deflection is zero, okay? That is at base deflection is zero. Therefore, y is equals to gamma h by 4 e I k to the power 4 plus now e raised to the power kh times a sine kh plus b cos kh means you have to substitute the value of x equals to h and substitute the value of y equals to 0 plus e raised to the power minus kh into c times sine kh plus d cos kh. This is equal to 0 because your y is equals to 0. Okay, so mark this as number 1, equation number 1. Okay, then apply the second boundary condition. So that is at x equals to h, your dy by dx equals to 0. That is at base, your slope is 0. At base, slope is equal to 0. Okay, if deflection is denoted by y, then the slope will be dy by dx. So you differentiate this expression with respect to x and then equate it to 0 and put the value of x equals to h. So therefore dy by dx is equals to gamma by 4 e I k to the power 4 plus k times e raised to the power minus kh e raised to the power kh, this term a sine becomes cos. Or let us first differentiate this and keep this term as it is. So it will be a sine kh plus b cos kh, okay, plus now differentiate this term and keep this term as it is. So again it will be k times e raised to the power kh, and this time a cos kh, and differentiation of cos will be minus sine, so it will be minus b sine kh. Okay, so what we have done here, we have to differentiate this term, and simultaneously we also put the value of x equals to h. So see, to differentiate this, we first differentiate e raised to the power kh with respect to x. So differentiating this, it will be k times e raised to the power kh, and this term is constant, okay, keeping this term as constant, okay, keeping this as constant, let us first differentiate this. So it will be k times e raised to the power kh into 1 into a sine kh plus b cos kh. Then you differentiate this term, you keep this as constant and differentiate this term. So it will be e raised to the power kh, and when differentiating a sine kh, it becomes a cos kh into k, okay, because this k is a constant, minus because the cos, differentiation of cos is minus sine, so it will be minus b sine kh again into k, because k is constant. So keeping k as common, taking it out, so it will be k times e raised to the power kh. Okay, then minus the second term, because when you differentiate this term first, so e raised to the power kh, differentiation of e raised to the power minus kh, differentiation of e raised to the power minus kh, it will be minus k times e raised to the power minus kh. Okay, same way the differentiation of a sine kh will be a cos kh into k, and differentiation of b cos kx will be minus b cos kh into k. So this becomes minus k e raised to the power minus kh, okay, and this will be now c sine kh plus d cos kh. Again this will be now we differentiate this is kept constant, and we differentiate this, so this will be now plus because here k is a positive value, so it will be k will be positive, into e raised to the power minus kh into c, differentiation of sine is cos, c cos kh minus d sin kh, okay, and this is equal to 0 because your slope is 0. So you can write this as, this expression can be written as simplifying. On simplifying, you can write this as dy by dx is equals to gamma by 4 ei k to the power 4 plus, now this and this is common, so we can write e k times e raised to the power kh into bracket a minus b a minus b sin kh plus a this a plus b a plus b cos kh. Okay, and same way for the another term, it will be minus k times e raised to the power minus kh into the bracket, or let us take this as plus value, so it will be c minus d cos kh and minus c minus d or c plus d sin kh equals to 0. So mark this as number 2. Now apply the third boundary condition. This is simplifying. Okay, now apply the third boundary condition, that is at x equals to 0, at x equals to 0, your d square y by dx square is 0, d square y by dx square equals to 0, that is the bending moment at the top is 0, that is at top bending moment is 0. So again you differentiate the above expression and substitute the value of x equals to 0 and equate this differential equation to 0. You will get another expression. So it will be d square y by dx square. Now we'll differentiate the second equation. So it will be equals to k square e to the power k into 0, because the x equals to 0, into minus 2b sine k into 0 plus 2a cos k into 0 plus k square into e raised to the power minus k into 0. This is multiplied with it is 2d sine k into 0 minus 2c cos k into 0. Means we have substituting k, it is k into x, but we substitute the value of x simultaneously. So we are differentiating as well as substituting the value of x also. So this has to be equated to 0. So mark this as number 3, and this will be equal to so we can write therefore k square into this term e raised to the power 0, it becomes e raised to the power 0, so it will be 1, the value of this will be 1. E raised to the power 0, so it becomes it is e raised to the power 0, so that means it is 1. Okay, then minus 2b. Now sine 0 is 0, so multiply by 0. Okay, so this term becomes 0. Okay, then plus 2a. Now cos 0 is 1, so multiply by cos 0 into 1 plus k square into again e raised to the power 0, so it will be 1. Then again sine 0 is 0, so multiply by 0 minus 2c. Now cos 0 is 1, so multiply by 1. This is equal to 0, so this implies your a is equal to c. Okay, the constant a is equals to c, because see here k square, this k square and this k square cancels out, so it will be 2a minus 2c equals to 0, so it will be a equals to c.
सर आवाज नहीं आ रही।
सर आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही है।
हेलो एम आई ऑडिबल? हेलो
यस सर
यस सर
यस सर
यस सर
यू विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ ए इक्वल्स टू सी. नाउ लेट अस अप्लाई द फोर्थ बाउंड्री कंडीशन. That is at x equals to 0, at x equals to 0, your shear force is 0. So your d cube y by dx cube means you have to do the third derivative of the y. This is equal to 0. That is, at x equals to 0, your shear force is 0. Okay, so the third derivative d cube y by dx cube is equals to this. If you do this derivative, then it will be equal to 2 k cube dot e raised to the power k, and simultaneously we put the value of x equals to 0, so e raised to the power kx, that means e raised to the power k into 0, and this is equal to minus a plus b sine k into 0 plus a minus b cos k into 0 plus 2 k cube dot e raised to the power minus k equal to 0 into 0. It will be it will be c minus d minus c minus d C minus D into sine again K into 0 plus C plus D plus C plus D cos K into 0, and this is equal to 0. Okay, this is equated to 0 because your d cube y by dx cube is 0. So again, this is your expression number 4. Okay, and when you solve this, you will get some another expression. So that means 2 k cube, this e raised to the power 0 is 1, into the sine 0 is 0. So this is 0, and a minus b into cos 0 is 1, so plus a minus b into 1, then this term plus 2 k cube, again this term is 0, so multiply by 1 into the power this c minus d sine 0 is 0, so this term becomes 0 plus c plus d into cos 0 is 1 equal to 0. So this implies, now we also know that a is equals to c. Okay, so a is equals to c, when you put a is equals to c, so it will becomes 2a minus b plus d. So you can write d is equals to b minus 2a. This is one other expression you will get. Because your c is equal to a. We are putting c is equals to a. Now from equation number 1, putting this d value and a equals to c, you will get y is equals to gamma h by 4 e I k to the power 4 plus e raised to the power kh into a tan kh plus b cos kh plus e raised to the power minus kh into the power a sin kh. Now put the value of c, the value of c is equals to, we are putting it as a, and substitute the value of d as b minus 2a. So plus b minus 2a times cos kh, this is equal to 0. Okay, so again or you can write simplifying this, on simplifying you will get y is equals to gamma h by 4 ei k to the power 4 plus, taking a as common, so it becomes a times sine kh into e raised to the power kh plus e raised to the power minus kh minus 2 e raised to the power minus kh into cos kh, and plus means we are separate, we are clubbing together the terms containing a and the terms containing b. So cos kh times e raised to the power kh plus e raised to the power minus kh, okay, this is equal to 0. This is this expression, we mark this as 1a, because this is already the expression number 1, and we are putting the value of a and c and d here. So let us mark this as 1a. So it is the same expression number 1, but it is modified with the values of c and d. And now we substitute the values of gamma and all the this values. So your y, so substitute this, all these values, the value of h and all, so it will be so 9.8 into 10 to the power 3 into 4, okay, divided by, that means this, okay, we are divided by 4 into e, 4 into e into i k raised to the power 4. I k raised to the power 4 is, we have already find this term, values of this term. So 12.418 into 10 to the power minus 4. Okay, this value is 4 into i, okay. Plus a times this sine kh into this term, so this will be equal to minus 0 point, you can verify this at your end, so 0.848 into 196.13 minus 2 into again this term, So it will be 1 divided by 196.13 into cos kh, that is 0.5366, okay, plus b into 0.5366 into 196.13. This is equal to 0. So this will give you another expression, that is a minus 0.6339 b is equal to 47530 divided by e. Okay, mark this as number 4. This relates the this is in the above expression we have substitute the values of c and d. So now our equation of y is in terms of a and b only. So to solve this this expression, we require now two such equations which contains two expressions which contains a and b. So this is one first expression. So this is number 5. And similarly expression number 2. So your number 2 will be dy by dx is equals to gamma by 4 e I k to the power 4 plus k e raised to the power kh into a minus b sine kh plus a plus b cos kh plus k times e raised to the power minus kh into a minus b plus 2a cos kh minus b minus a sine kh. This is equal to 0. Now again simplifying this term, it will be gamma by 4 e I k to the power 4 plus a times k sine kh into e raised to the power kh minus e raised to the power minus kh plus k cos kh into e raised to the power kh plus e raised to the power minus kh plus 2 k e minus kh e raised to the power minus kh dot into the power sine kh plus cos kh. Okay, this is the first part plus second part, that is b in terms of b, means we are clubbing together the terms containing a and b. K cos kh into e raised to the power kh minus e raised to the power minus kh and minus के साइन के एच डॉट ई रेज टू द पावर के एच प्लस ई रेज टू द पावर माइनस के एच एंड दिस इज इक्वल टू जीरो. नाउ वी सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यूज ऑफ ऑल दिस टर्म्स. सो इट विल बी दिस इम्प्लाइज 9.81 or 9.8. into 10 to the power 3 divided by 4 e into this 12. I k square k raised to the power 4 is 12.418 into 10 to the power minus 4. Okay, plus a into you substitute all these values, it will be minus 1.3197 into 0.8438 into 196.13 plus 1.196.13 plus 1.3197 into 0.5366 into 196.13. Okay, this part plus this 2 into 1.3197 divided by 196.13 into minus 0.8438 plus 0.5366. Plus b into 1.3197 into 0.5366 into 196.13 plus 1.3197 plus 1.3197 into 0.8438 into 196.13. This is equal to 0. So this will give you another expression in terms of a and b. So it will be a minus 4.493 into b is equals to 248.14 divided by e. Okay, mark this as number 6. Okay, so now equation number 5 and 6, solving equation 5 and 6 we get the values of a and b. The value of a is 51264 divided by e, and b is equal to 5887 divided by e. Okay, and now you substitute the values of a and b in the equation of y. You will get the final equation of y without any unknown constants. So your y now becomes y times gamma x y is equals to gamma times x divided by 4EI k to the power 4 plus A sine kx into e raised to the power kx plus e raised to the power minus kx plus b cos kx into e raised to the power kx plus e raised to the power minus kx minus 2a e raised to the power minus kx cos kx. Okay, so this is the final expression. So substitute the values of gamma and all, so you will get y is equals to 197.3 into 10 to the power 4 divided by e into x plus 51264, that is the value of a, divided by e into this sine k x into e raised to the power kx plus e raised to the power minus kx. Now substitute the values of b, so 5887 divided by e into cos kx into e raised to the power kx plus e raised to the power minus kx, and the last term minus 2 into a, the value of a, into 51264 divided by e, that is a. So this is the values of a, this is the value of b, and this is also the value of a. Into e raised to the power minus kx into cos kx. Okay, so that is the value of the y, that value means deflection. So this will give you the deflection. Okay, so but our interest is to find the hoop tension. So the hoop tension is given by PR, the radial pressure is equals to 4TE divided by D square into Y. Okay. So substituting all the values of the y, you will get the value of PR is equals to 9800 into x plus 2554 sine kx into e raised to the power kx e raised to the power kx plus e raised to the power minus kx plus 29.20 cos kx into this e raised to the power kx kx plus e raised to the power minus kx minus 519 into e raised to the power minus kx into cos kx. So this is the value of the PR, and similarly you can find the value of moment of resistance. The moment moment at any section x minus EI d square y by dx square. So I am skipping some of the steps and directly writing the expression mx is equal to minus 73.1 cos kx e raised to the power kx minus e raised to the power minus kx plus 8.40 sin kx e raised to the power kx minus e raised to the power minus kx plus 146.2 e raised to the power minus kx into sin kx. Okay, so using these two expression, now you can make a table similar to the one given in the IS 3370 for the particular example. So if you make a table now, x, write the value of x in meter, PR, that is the radial pressure in Newton per meter square, okay, and mx in Newton meter per meter. So at x equals to 0 meter, it will be minus 452 and the moment will be 0. And at x equals to 1 meter, you substitute these values here. So it will be 10787 and this will be 3. Okay. And at x equals to 2 meter, it will be 21002 and it will be 918. And at 2.5 meter, it will be 22669 and here it will be 1918, and at 3 meter it will be 18593 and this value will be 2299, and at 3.5 this will be 8242 and this will be minus 158, and at x equals to 4 meter, that is the full height, this radial pressure will be 0 and this will be minus 9083. So and at x also, at x equals to 2.33 meter, at x equals to 2.33 meter, your PR is maximum. You have also have to find the maximum value of radial pressure, and that will be equal to 228. You can see the value is in between 2 and 2.5, because the maximum value will be in between 2 and 2.5. So you have to by trial and error you can find the maximum value of the PR 834 Newton per meter square, that is the maximum radial pressure. then at x equals to 4 meter, your maximum bending moment, your bending moment is maximum. Okay, so out of this you have to find the critical ones. So your maximum bending moment, that is negative bending moment, is equal to minus 9083 newton meter per meter. Okay, that is maximum negative bending moment. Then at x equals to 2.9, see again the value of the positive maximum bending moment lies between 2.5 to 3. So at 2.9 it will be the maximum. So maximum positive bending moment is equal to 2360 newton meter per meter. This is the maximum positive bending moment. So now once you have the this value, this is summarizing. We are interested in the whole derivation. We are interested in these three values only, okay, because for the design purpose we require these values: the maximum radial pressure, the maximum negative bending moment, and maximum positive bending moment. And this thing you can also get from the IS 3370 part 4. Okay, so once you have this, then we can do the design. So now let us design the sidewalls. Design of sidewalls for hoop tension. So maximum hoop tension is equal to this 22834 newton per meter square. Okay, so maximum hoop force, will be equal to PR. Let this be T, we call this as T. So T is equals to PR times D by 2. So that is equal to 22834 into diameter. Diameter is 11.7 divided by 2. So your maximum T, therefore T is equals to 133580 newton per meter height of wall. This is the tension in the wall. So for this tension you can now find the hoop steel. So hoop steel required, we call this as ASH, is equal to T by sigma ST, that is permissible tensile stress in steel. So 133580 divided by this mild steel, the permissible stress is 115. Okay, because for mild steel, sigma ST is equals to 115 newton per mm square. Okay, so you will get ASH, that is the hoop steel, ASH is equals to 1162 mm square. Okay, this is for the maximum value of the hoop tension. But as we know that at different height the radial pressure also varies, So you can also make a table and find the corresponding hoop tension and hoop force, and then you can find the corresponding hoop steel required for that. So let us provide steel on both faces, because our thickness of the wall is 170, so we can either provide it centrally or we can provide on each faces or on both faces. But here for resisting the moment, we will be providing steel on both the faces. So that is why let us provide the hoop steel also on both the faces. So therefore, area of hoop reinforcement on each face will be equal to 1162 by 2, that is 581 mm square. So therefore, provide 12 mm dia at the rate 190 mm center to center on each face. Okay, so your ASH provided is equal to 2 into 590 mm square, that is equal to 1189 mm square, and this is greater than 1162 mm square required. This is greater than ASH required equals to 1162 mm square. Therefore, okay. Now we also have to check the tensile stress in the wall, that and make sure that the tensile stresses are not exceeded. If they are exceeded, then we have to increase the steel accordingly. So the tensile stress in wall is equals to T divided by B, that is per meter, B into T plus M minus 1 into AST, or we can say ASH. ASH. Okay, so this will be equal to 133580 divided by 1000 into thickness is 170 plus M for modular ratio for this M25 grade is 10.98 minus 1 10.98 minus 1 into 1189, the steel provided. Okay, and this comes out to be 0.734 Newton per mm square, and this is less than sigma CBT bending tension. Okay, and that value is 1.8 newton per mm square. So that is okay. So the maximum tension, the tensile stress is in the wall due to maximum tension. That is due to maximum tension. Maximum tension is within the permissible value. So there is no issue of tensile stresses exceeding the permissible value. And at the end, you can also make a table summarizing the design, that at x, x in meter, radial pressure in newton per meter square, then the tensile force in newton per meter, height of the wall, then you can find ASH required in mm square per meter, height of the wall. Then you can also put ASH provided in mm square per meter, height of the wall. And finally, you can also check tensile stresses in newton per mm square. Okay, so this table you can make and summarize your design at different height, because at different height your radial pressure will be different. So you can also curtail your steel, because the one we have designed is for the maximum radial pressure, but at as we go move along the height of the wall, the radial pressure varies, so we can find the corresponding steel and provide as if required. So this was about the hoop tension. Similar exercise you have to do for the bending action also. Okay, this was for the hoop tension. So now design the section for, let us keep some space. Design of section for cantilever action, for cantilever action. So now we will be designing for bending. Okay, so your fundamentals of working water tank is now used here. In the fundamental topic, we have gone through design of members subjected to axial tension only, and design of bending only, and we have also gone through design of members subjected to combined bending and tension. So this is an example of combined bending and tension. We have first designed for the radial pressure, that is for the tension, and now we are designing it for the bending moment also. So maximum bending moment is equal to 9083 kilonewton or newton meter. It was in newton meter. Newton meter. So you can find the parameters, design parameters. K is equals to m sigma cbc divided by m sigma cbc plus sigma st. So this will be equal to 0.448. This is for m20 or m25. For M25 and mild steel reinforcement. Okay, the design parameters, same way your the value of J will be 1 minus K by 3, so it will be 0.851, and the value of Q is equals to 1 by 2 sigma CBC J into K, so that will be 1.620. Okay, see, these are based on the for M25, your the value of sigma CBC, you can get it from the table given in IS 3370, part 2, Newton per mm square. Modular ratio is 10.98, and sigma S is equal to sigma S is equals to 115 Newton per mm square, that is for mild steel. So with this you can now design for the design moment of this value. Okay, so let us first find the D required. So D required is equals to M by Q times B. So that is equal to the moment is 9083 into 10 to the power 3. We are converting the meter into mm, and all the terms are put in Newton and mm only. So 1.62 into 1000. So it will be 74.88 mm. Okay. Let us say 75 mm. Okay, and the depth we have provided is more than this. The overall, so overall depth required, or we can say D, capital D required, will be equal to 75 plus cover requirement 25 plus 12 by 2. That is the effective cover. This is the effective cover. So we call this as T required because we have used term T required. So this T required comes out to be 106 mm. Okay, and as per our initial assumption, the T provided is T is equals to 170 mm. Therefore, okay. Now, let us find the effective depth provided. So effective depth D is equal to 170 minus this value, that is 25 clear cover plus 12 by 2. We are assuming 12 mm diameter over here. So based on the hoop steel, we have used 12 dia, so that is why we are using the 12. So it will be 139 mm. Okay, so now you can find the area of the steel. Area of steel required, AST required is equals to M by sigma ST J into D. So M is 9083 into 10 to the power 3 divided by sigma ST is 115. The value of J we have found 0.851, and the value of D is 139. So from this you will get AST required equals to 668 mm square. So let us provide 12 mm diameter bar. To provide 12 mm at the rate 160 mm center to center at the water face. Okay, means inside. So this is for the negative reinforcement, okay, negative bending moment. Okay, this steel, because we have considered the moment, maximum negative moment, and the negative moment will be the steel for the negative moment will be provided on the water face. And what about the earth face, means outside, okay, this is in inner side. Okay, what about the outer side? So for that we again have to find the steel required for the same procedure you have to do it for the moment of this much 2360 positive moment 2360. So for maximum positive bending moment M is equal to this is over here. Okay, now we are doing for the outside face. So 2360 Newton meter per meter. Okay, so similar procedure you can do and find the steel required on the outer face. Okay, so I hope you get this and you will be able to do it of your own. Okay, so we stop here. In one more class we'll go through the tables, how to solve these examples using the tables directly. So we'll take one more class for this, and how you can use the tables given in IS 3370 part 4 to solve this, and how the things become simple, because all the exercise will be reduced, because you have the coefficients of the moments, positive moments, negative moments, as well as the radial pressure. So you just have to multiply these coefficients with some factor, and you will get the design moments and design pressure. So using those pressure, you can then design the section. So let's stop here. If you have any doubt in today's lecture, then we can discuss. Any doubt?
Sir, exam ke liye syllabus kaun sa hoga?
Up to the last lecture, means almost circular tank will be there, flat slab, fundamentals of water tank, and the circular tanks. And it will be MCQ based. Okay, so any other question?